powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
And today we'll consider the 100 scriptures that changed my life. And this is the part 4 of this teaching, 100 scriptures that changed my life. And today we'll be looking at Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18. It said, "But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that gave thee the power to get wealth, that he may establish his covenant which he has sworn unto thy fathers, as it is this day. Remember the Lord your God. It is him that gave the power to get wealth." We can't truly walk in supernatural wealth without God empowering us to have the experience. We can only have the experience when we function according to his word. When I read this scripture many years ago, I've read it of a recent tune. Many years ago, when I read this scripture, "And the Lord your God that gave you the power to get wealth," it made a meaning in my heart that it is God who gives the power to get wealth. So the power to get wealth comes from God. And this is why your relationship with God is important, because it is only him that can empower you to walk in supernatural world. We cannot truly walk in supernatural world without God empowering us. So it am the Lord your God that gave you the power to get well. The next scripture that ministered to me was in Deuteronomy 28. I love it so much. In Deuteronomy 28, let's read from next one. "It shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God," you see, responding to the voice of God will change your perspective to life. Responding to God's voice is the pathway to supernatural living. I said, responding to God's voice is the pathway to supernatural living. We cannot truly rise above the limitation and the circumstances of life except we choose to walk according to his word. When God's word becomes the foundation for your thinking, nothing can be impossible to you. When God's word becomes the foundation for your thinking, nothing can be impossible to you. Dreams come to pass, visions come to pass, when God's word becomes the foundation for the things we do. So the scripture said, "And it shall come to pass, if thou wilt hearken diligently to the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all the nations of the earth." When you obey, when you respond to his word, when you make God's word the foundation for your lifestyle, the foundation for your thinking, the Lord your God will raise you on high above all the nations of the earth. Obedience is the pathway to unlocking supernatural prosperity. Obedience is the pathway to unlocking supernatural prosperity. Obedience is the pathway to unlocking supernatural prosperity. If you walk in obedience, you're going to experience greater possibilities in life. You know, some people are trying to make it happen, but walking in obedience is the doorway to supernatural results. Walking in obedience, making God's word the foundation for your way of doing things. So he said here, if you hearken to the voice of the Lord your God, he will set you on high. That made me to think, if I will obey God, if I will put his word first, if I will allow his word to prevail in my thinking, in my action, in my way of doing things, he was going to set me on high above all the nations of the earth. Can I say this to you? True prosperity comes when we walk in obedience. I said true prosperity comes when we walk in obedience. True prosperity comes when we walk in obedience. Walking in obedience is the doorway to true prosperity, the prosperity that will stay, the prosperity that will be stable when we obey his word. When we allow his word to influence our way of thinking. So verse 2 said, and all these blessings shall come on thee. Why is the blessing going to come on us? Why are we going to experience the blessing? Because we are walking in obedience. And walking in obedience is the doorway to greater things of the Spirit. You know, God wants to promote those who respond to his word. He wants to increase them. He wants to prophetically, he wants to position them in the right places at the right given time. Obedience will take you to greater things of the Spirit. If you walk in obedience, if you allow God's word to take the lead in the things you do, nothing can be impossible to you. This is the key. Obey God. Do his word. Put his word first. When I read that scripture, then he said, all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee. So for the blessing to overtake you, it means you must be a man of the Spirit. A man who walked in obedience. A man who projects God's word above his emotion, above his feeling. He's making the word of God the standard for his living. So he said, all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee if thou will hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. So the blessing was conditioned to obedience. The same thing in the new covenant today. If you don't walk, you know, James said that the doers of the word is blessed. He said the doers of the word. You know, some people don't want to do the word of God. God asks them to walk in love. They don't want to walk in love. God asks them to forgive. They don't want to forgive. God asks them to walk by faith. They don't want to walk by faith. So how are you going to see the manifestation of the blessing? Already you have the blessing. But to experience the manifestation of the blessing, you have to walk by faith. And to walk by faith, you have to respond to God's word. And responding to his word is what brings supernatural change. Responding to his word is what brings supernatural change. So if I want to see supernatural change in my life, I have to submit myself to God's word and make it the foundation for my way of doing things. The next scripture that ministered to me was Deuteronomy 28 verse 3. It said, blessed shall that be in the city and blessed shall that be in the field. This is what happened. When you begin to do the word, when you go out, you're blessed. When you come in, you're blessed. A lot of people will look at you and they'll be wondering, what is happening to this man? This man is experiencing a different life. He's prospering in difficult places, in places where there are hardship, where there are difficulty, where there are stress. He's prospering because he has made the word of God the foundation for his way of doing things. And blessed shall thou be in the city, and blessed shall thou be in the city. Blessed shall thou be in the city. So when you walk in the city, you're blessed, and blessed will you be in the field. Verse 4 said, and blessed shall be the fruit of thy ground, the fruit of your ground. You know, in the days of the old covenant, there were a lot of agricultural activity that was going on. He said, yeah, your ground is going to be blessed. Your ground is not going to be cursed. It can be likened to your job. Blessed shall be your job. Blessed will be your job. Blessed will be your job because you make the word of God your final authority. Blessed will be your job. Blessed will be your home. And he went forward to say here, he said, blessed shall be the fruit of thy ground and the fruit of the, sorry, blessed shall be the fruit of thy body. That's the first thing. I made a mistake there. In Deuteronomy 28 verse 4, he said, blessed shall be the fruit of thy body. That's the first thing. The fruit of your body. Your babies will be blessed. Your children will be blessed. Blessed will be the fruit of your body. The next is the fruit of thy ground. You know, in agriculture, he was telling them that your ground, if you plant things are going to come off the fruit of thy ground, and the fruit of thy cattle, and the increase of thy kind, and the flock of thy sheep. You can see the blessing exploding. Because the fruit of your body, the fruit of your ground, and he went forward to talk about the cattle, your cattle will do well. Your cattle are going to do well. You know, cattle today may be likened to your businesses, may be likened to your product, may be likened to the services you offer to other organizations, and they will pay you. He said, blessed is it's going to be. Verse 5 said, blessed shall be thy basket and thy store. Blessed will be your basket and your store. This is what he said. Your basket is blessed. Your business is blessed. Your ministry is blessed. Your job is blessed. Because you have obeyed the Lord your God, he said, blessed shall be thy basket. Everything becomes blessed because you choose God's way of doing things. He said here in Exodus, he said, blessed shall thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shall thou be when thou goest out. He said, you will be blessed when you come in. He said, you will be blessed when you go out. So if you're going out for your job, for your business, for whatever God has called you to do, he's already blessed. He's already blessed because walking in obedience is the doorway to unlocking supernatural increase. I said, walking in obedience is the doorway to unlocking supernatural increase. He said, you're going out with the blessed. He said, you're coming in with the blessed. So every time you're on the road, you're on the aircraft, or you're in a boat, or you are driving, he said, it is blessed. Why is it blessed? Because you have obeyed the Lord your God. Because you have put his word first. Because you have allowed his word to prevail in your thinking, in your action and conversation. And right now, the blessing is exploding in your going out and in your coming in. And he said, verse 7 said, the Lord shall cause thy enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. Wow. The Lord will cause the enemy. So if people want to rise against you, if a situation wants to rise against you, he said, the Lord is going to cause it to fail. We're reading Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 7. Deuteronomy 28, verse 7. The Lord will cause thy enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face. They shall come out against thee one way. They shall flee before thee seven ways. Wow. What a supernatural protection. This is supernatural protection in operation. Supernatural protection, that you're protected from every wind of evil. You're protected from every form of wickedness. You're protected from every form of anxiety and worry. The Lord is at work protecting you. Verse 8 said, the Lord will shall command a blessing upon thee. This is powerful. Deuteronomy 28, verse 8. The Lord shall command the blessing upon thee in thy storehouse and in all that thou settest thy hand unto, and he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. He will bless thee in the land. Wow. The blessing in the land. Folks can explain why you prosper the way you do. Folks can explain that the things that come against others try to come against you, but you succeeded with it because of the blessing of the Lord that is upon your life. When the blessing is in operation, there is no limit to what you can achieve. There is no limit to what you can experience, and there is no limit to what you can manifest. The blessing empowers. It helps you to rise beyond every form of limitation or opposition that will not contain with your dream and your vision. The blessings of the Lord. He said, the Lord command a blessing upon thee. The Lord command a blessing because obedience is opening door for unusual manifestation of the blessing. The Lord commands the blessing on thee. When that blessing is in operation, it helps you to excel beyond your contemporaries. Before your contemporaries will come, you're ahead of them. You're doing things far beyond human imagination because the blessings of the Lord is in operation in your life. This is the key to effective living and productive living. God wants you to be productive, and the blessing is what will cause you to be productive. And when the blessing is in operation, you begin to maximize the wisdom of God in things in different areas, because now you're going to enjoy the leadership of the Spirit, and great things will begin to happen. Amazing things will begin to happen. He said, the blessing. Look at this here. I want to read it again. Deuteronomy 28, verse 8. The Lord shall command a blessing upon thee in thy storehouse and in all that thou settest thy hand unto, and he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Verse 9 said, the Lord shall establish thee a holy people unto himself, as he has sworn unto thee. if thou wilt keep the commandment of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways. This is powerful. Walking in his way will cause the things you do to be established, will cause his will for your life, for your future to be established. When you walk in his way, he will cause things to be established. This is how you become more productive, you become more effective, you become a person of excellence. When you walk in his way, you become established. No matter the storms of life, you always rise against it. No matter the circumstances of life, you're going to rise against it. He will establish you to produce the God kind of result. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. These scriptures have the potential to transform your thinking and inspire you to take the lead in the direction of God's will. Now, the verse 10 said, verse 10, Deuteronomy 28, verse 10, and all the people of the earth shall see that are called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee, O my God. When people see your commitment to God, they cannot put you in fear. They cannot come against you. When they see your commitment to the Lord, a commitment to the Lord will lead to supernatural security. We're going to be secured. There is something that happens to people who have yielded themselves to the Spirit of God. Great and mighty things should begin to happen. Amazing things should begin to break out when you commit yourself to the things of the Lord. When you commit yourself to kingdom service. When you commit yourself to supporting the advancement of the kingdom, the expansion of the kingdom. If that is what consumes your passion, your thinking, your way of doing things, there's going to be amazing acceleration of the Spirit far beyond your human imagination. Now, I want to look at this scripture. Look at verse 11 said, and the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods. The Lord will make you plenteous in goods, and in the fruit of thy body. The Lord will make you plenteous, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and the fruit of thy ground, in the land which the Lord sworn unto thy fathers to give thee. God is going to give lands, properties, real estate. This is part of the promise. When you walk in obedience, when you walk by his word, when you make the kingdom your priority. That was why Jesus said in Matthew 6:33, he said, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you. How are things going to be added to you when the kingdom becomes your ultimate priority? He said, these things, you're not going to struggle for them. You're not going to fight for them. But these things begin to add to you because the Spirit of God is in operation. Verse 12 said, the Lord will open unto thee his good treasure. Wow. Opening his good treasure. When the good treasure is open, ideas, inspiration, insight, concept, creativity comes to you because the Lord has opened his good treasure. And this is what is happening right now. His good treasure is open to you. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. The heavens to give rain. The heavens to give rain. The heavens to give rain unto thy land in his season. And to bless all the work of thy hand, and thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. Wow. Thou shalt lend unto the nations. From this day forward, see yourself as the lender, not as the borrower. See yourself as the lender. He said, thou shalt lend unto the nation, and thou shalt not borrow. Because the blessing, 100 scriptures that changed my life, well, we were doing the part 4, and I'm almost... Let's look at Deuteronomy 28, verse 12. It said, the Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure. Why is he going to open the good treasure? Because he wants you to prosper. He wants you to excel. He wants you to take the lead because you have obeyed his word. The heaven to give rain. The heaven to give rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the works of thy hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow. This is the will of God, that you will lend to nation, but you will not borrow. Can you make this your thinking? Can you make this your pathway to your lifestyle? That's whatever you want to do. You want to consider the word of God above any situation. You will lend. You'll be a giver. You will be a blessing. You will not be the one struggling with finances because you have obeyed God, because you have made his word your priority. The last scripture on this section is verse 13. And the Lord will make thee the head and not the tail. This is powerful. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail. You will be the head and not the tail. And thou shalt be above only. Hallelujah. You'll be above only. You'll be above only. And thou shalt be above only. And thou shalt not be beneath. If thou hearken unto the commandment of the Lord thy God, which I commanded this day to observe and to do them. He said, you'll be above only. This is your destiny. This is who you are. Above only. Why? Because you're the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You're a partaker of the divine nature. And because the life of God is in you, nothing can be impossible to you. If you're watching this broadcast today and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God has raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray that prayer with me, you said born again, and the Holy Ghost is going to lead you from this day forward. You will not remain the same. And also, I want to encourage you to consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. When you subscribe to our YouTube channel, you'll be able to watch life-changing broadcasts that can empower you to take the lead in the direction of His will. And also encourage you to keep watching finishworktv.com. Finishwork TV is a ministry on the cutting edge, helping many around the world to receive the engrafted word of God. And also, you can consider partnering with us. You know, partnership is strategic when it comes to spreading the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. So you can partner with us today on PayPal. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. And also you can send us friends request on Facebook. It's Faithman Ogboada. Faithman Ogboada on Facebook. And you can follow my official page. It's Apostle Faithman Ogboada. Until my next broadcast, don't ever forget this. There is greatness.